The best way to experience any new destination is to travel like a local. Here is a Canberra local's recommendation on some of the best autumn winter activities in our nation's capital. So we will commence day one with a visit to one of our cultural icons, followed by high tea, a visit to a distillery, and a lovely experience on Lake Pialligo.
City of mine, how I love the city of mine. It never gets me down, city of mine, how I love.
So welcome to Old Parliament House. This is one of the most remarkable buildings in Australia. So 1927 this building opened, so 61 years this building was the home of our federal parliament, and it is the people's place. So this is a building where we would have politicians, we would have staffers, all sorts of people coming together in this building, and it is a celebration of all of our stories coming together. So incredibly significant. And here we are in 2022, and it is 95 years since the building opened. And not only are we a building that celebrates the beautiful story of Australian democracy through the Parliament, but we are the Museum of Australian Democracy as well. And we have remarkable contemporary exhibition experiences alongside beautiful spaces like what you can see behind me here. So if you are a family with young children, there are terrific spaces here for you as well to understand the very beginnings of democracy and learn with us over time. So, and if you are a school student, we have 90,000 school students coming through a year, and older people come through, all sorts of different people, and people from overseas who come who are really interested in exploring both the history of Australia's really unique democracy, but also thinking about the kinds of things in a contemporary Australian democracy that are important. So the importance of free press, for example. So we have a terrific exhibition about that. Every year we have a fantastic exhibition called Behind the Lines, which is all about political cartooning. And as we know, that's really central to the conversation about Australian democracy as well. We encourage you to come and visit, and you will find that you will be here for hours and hours and hours.
My name is Adam Myatt, and I'm the General Manager at Hyatt Hotel Canberra. After you've had your fill of the cultural icons that are all within very close proximity of our hotel, why don't you pop by and try one of our high teas? Hyatt Hotel Canberra is a hotel that has operated in one form or another since 1924, and a lot of the old heritage building remains to this day. The tea lounge at Hyatt Hotel Canberra includes two beautiful courtyards, the Rose Courtyard and the Lavender Courtyard. The lounge itself is a lovely setting of Art Deco design. Our high tea menu, served in one of our extensive high tea stands, has been creatively put together by our very skilled culinary team. The ingredients are locally sourced and are sure to delight the palates of even the most discerning high tea guest. We have an array that includes savory items as well as sweet items and a wonderful range of teas to accompany your afternoon tea. In addition to that, we also have champagne. We serve a beautiful sparkling wine or a Veuve Clicquot that also accompanies our afternoon tea.
Hi, my name's Paul. Welcome to the Canberra Distillery. Canberra Distillery is the first distillery in Canberra. A bit about the distillery, started back in 2015 by the owner, Tim Reardon. If you're looking for something to do on a weekend, why don't you come and join us for a tasting here at the distillery itself, here in Mitchell. We have over 18 different products that include whiskies, we've got some rums, we've got vodkas, we've got some gins. We are most famous for our gins. There's quite a range for us. Feel free to come in. We are open Monday to Friday. That's from 9 till 3. We're also open on Saturdays, every Saturday from 10 till 4. What we love the most of all is actually bringing you guys into the distillery. We do tours, we do experiences. We can like to do some catering and things like that for you as well. But the most popular option is just coming in and tasting our full range of products.
G'day guys, my name is Sandy. I'm the owner and exec chef for Aura Catering, Feeding Your Senses. We have a wide range of stuff available on our catering company. You know, we specialize in weddings, high tea, happy hour, you know, cocktails, picnic hampers. We are famous for our grazing boxes. They come all different sizes, medium, large. You know, you can order from savory, sweet, cheese. You know, we're all about for clients, so if you're coming to Canberra for a night out, picnic, or a go boat, get in contact with us. We will cater for any needs you have.
Not dead yet, true shit. So why do I worry about what I can see? I've been stressing about money for my rent, but the money that I spent last night with my friends was worth.
Hello, welcome to GoBoat Canberra. When you're taking a GoBoat out, you can experience Lake Burley Griffin. In a 1 hour booking, you'll go out underneath Kings Avenue Bridge, sailing past the Carillion. You'll see the War Memorial Parliament House. You'll get to roughly the water fountain and back in that time frame. With a 2 hour booking, you can continue on going underneath Commonwealth Avenue Bridge, past the museum, you'll see the yacht club. You'll probably get out to roughly Springbank Island and back in that time frame. And then if you wanted a 3 hour booking, you can stop at Springbank Island and enjoy that beautiful area, or you can continue sailing on out past Black Mountain Peninsula and back within the time frame. When hiring a GoBoat, you don't need a license. We are pet friendly and you can have up to 8 people on board the boat. The boat has a central picnic table, so perfect for families, birthdays, different celebrations.
Look into my eyes, eyes, eyes. It's gonna be alright, right, right. Tomorrow's gonna be okay. One moment, one shot.
Day 2 will see us rise bright and early for a hot air balloon ride, followed by a visit to the National Gallery of Australia, some of Canberra's finest dining at Pialligo Estate, not forgetting to check out the cool climate wine region, and ending the day off with a fine bar of our choice.
Calling me, oh, like the rainbow.
I'm Kim, one of the pilots of Balloon Aloft Canberra. A balloon flight is a must-do activity when you visit the nation's capital. Canberra is defined by proximity and diversity. As you fly over our beautiful city, take the time to enjoy architectural masterpieces, tree-lined suburbs, international sporting venue, and some of Australia's most recognizable attractions. I hope to share our amazing views and stories with you sometime soon. Come and fly with me.
Gallery of Australia, you can experience one of the most magnificent collections of Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander art in the country. Indeed, we hold the largest collection of this art in the world. You can also see wonderful displays of Australian art and international art. My favourite part of the National Gallery of Australia is the building. The building is extraordinary. It's built in a brutalist style. It's contrapuntal, it has angles, it has vistas, it has sight lines. It is a really unusual space, and not only are we home to a magnificent collection, and you can see great art here, but you can also see phenomenal architecture. And if you're keen on sculpture, you can go outside and experience the sculpture garden, which is located on the shores of Lake Burley Griffin. If you haven't visited the National Gallery of Australia in autumn, you really must, particularly the sculpture garden. The garden changes colour, the leaves change, the smells change, and it's more misty. We see the leaves change from that deep green into those autumnal colours, and the sculptures come out through the mists and the cold. It's a wonderful time to be here in Canberra.
What's your weakness? What's your type? Somehow I wanna know all about you. Deep connection, lights a spark. You already know me when we dance in the dark. We're dreamers.
We have a fully working farm on site. We have an olive grove that you might be able to see just directly behind me. So we press those olives to make our oils, and we have an orchard which has just over 1,000 fruit trees. We have a market garden where we grow all of our own fruit and veg, and two poly houses which sort of help with our season. We also now have bees on site, which one is for honey, but then also now we're lucky enough to sort of have them helping us with our little ecosystem that we've created on site. And all of that is fed into the restaurant every day, picked fresh. I think the thing that separates what we do from just about anywhere else almost in the country is just how reliant we are on growing our own produce. So we have some really, really beautiful heirloom varieties, and you know, we work really, really hard with the garden team to make sure that we utilize everything that comes out of there. And I guess when you come out here, you know, not only is the venue one of the most beautiful places you'll ever see, but the service is always very lovely, and we really are sort of doing something quite unique, and there's a lot of reasons that make this place really special. So going into autumn, we'll start seeing some really, really lovely produce that comes out of the garden. So things like a couple of varieties of pumpkins, Jerusalem artichokes, which are probably one of my favourite ingredients. I've never met a Jerusalem artichoke I didn't like. So there's some really, really beautiful sort of root vegetables, some really like lovely sort of early stage sort of, we call them winter greens, but you know, things like cavallonero and kales and all that kind of thing as well.
Hi everyone, if you're considering visiting the Canberra region during autumn and winter, which is a must visit region, you really should also look at the cool climate wineries in the area. Out at Shore Wines in Murrum Bateman, we're only 25 minutes away driving, or you can grab a helicopter and come out here in 10 minutes. We have a wide range of tasting experiences to suit all customers, big range of wines. We're open 9 to 5, have a fantastic time in the cool climate wine region of Canberra.
Welcome to Bar Beirut. Bar Beirut is the place to be for beats, eat, vibes, love, and cocktails. Where nobody cares about your religion, race, or the hand you want to hold. Our bars in Beirut looks exactly the same what I built here, just to show and make you feel this buzz we have at home. At this bar in particular, our food is Middle Eastern and Mediterranean inspired, Lebanese inspired cuisine. So at Bar Beirut, after 10 p.m., this is where things change. This is where the music gets a little bit louder, more belly dance style. Same as on Wednesday, we run all these burlesque show. After burlesque, we have, or before sometimes, we have a belly dancer show, louder music, open till late night, every night till 2 a.m., on the weekend till 4 a.m. All the people that want to belly dance and hear something with the Middle Eastern flavor, Middle Eastern shimmies, they come to Bar Beirut. We are known about the late night parties and they are great.
We recommend a quiet start to day 3. Comfort food, some of Canberra's best comfort food is what we'll feature, and a visit to one of our favorite truffle farms.
Hi, my name is Sasha Broadberg and co-creator of Broadberg with my wife, Joelle. We've been operational since about 2008 over at Bowen Park at the lake. And now where we are is at Capital Brewing & Co. in Derry Lane. Yeah, we've always been working out of a caravan. We've always loved food. I used to work in hospitality for many, many years and then decided to do comfort food, you know, something that everybody wants. And we came up with Broad. And yeah, I think we're doing a pretty good job. Our best burgers I got, they're all amazing, but we started off with the Broad Burger, which is a classic. And then from there you can get a Broad Deluxe, which is a lot bigger. And what we strive for is just quality ingredients. You know, we even opened up our own butchery to make sure that our product's even better. Well, my favorite burger, which I create, which isn't on the menu, is a Broad Burger with blues, Swiss, and bacon. It just gives that beautiful touch of a little bit of bite and then the smoothness of the Swiss, and then you get that, you know, amazing crispy bacon as well.
Truffle trees, and I have a truffle right here in my hand, were planted in 2008, and then in 2013 we planted a second plantation. The truffle I have in my hand here weighs 90 grams, and we harvested that this morning. We have sort of a number of prices that you could actually look at for this 190 gram truffle. You would get anything from $270 to $198 if you bought it here on the farm. This truffle smells particularly wonderful because it hasn't been cleaned yet. It's got a delightful aroma, and if you smelt it, you would want to use it with food straight away. Truffle enhances the flavours of foods. It is unknown that people have allergies to truffle. Canberra region, as you probably know, is actually famous in winter for all its truffle hunts and everything like that. At this time of year, you may think the area is cold, but it's the cold that actually ripens the truffle, and it's what we like in the region. At Mason Mist, we are a farm. I'm not a chef, but I cook with truffle, and I enjoy cooking with truffle and sharing any experiences that I have.
Thank you for taking the time to watch this video. I really hope you enjoyed our nation's capital. I wish you safe travels either back home or onwards to the snow. If you are a Canberra local, feel free to tag your favourite tourism operator in the comments section. Take good care.